Good evening, everybody. Welcome to some more painting. I'm just gonna get into it here tonight because we have a few things to do. Oops. Let's get the right thing on there. Nope. So talk to my player, and she says that is the wrong flesh tone, so we're gonna fix that for her. And then we're gonna step into getting Lutheria and this dragon done as well, because we're gonna need them fairly shortly, so. But you can see that we've got Lutheria all primed and ready to go. And of course, our dragon as well, who's a very big boy. So we'll do our best to paint so we can see things here. I might have to move the camera a little bit just to kind of get a better angle. I'm looking at a different method of being able to display my camera so that we can get a better view of things. So hopefully that will be soon. But anyway, first up, we're going to finish our player character, get that done, and move on from there.
Thank you. Thank you.
great part about painting miniatures is if you screw up, paint over it and try it again. Which is gonna happen with you when you're doing eyes. Because eyes are awful. Try not to put too much detail usually into the eyes because they're so tiny. Have to remember that they are going to be not as noticeable when not under a magnifying glass as well. So any slight detail that you're not crazy about, I'm not gonna see it. Further requests, and apparently camera angle is bad. I'm gonna do this. We have to make some changes here when we can. focus all wrong. Screwing it up too bad. How's that look, my dear? Since I know that you're watching. Flashy than what you're looking for. I made it a little thicker on this arm just because its arm is up and the cloth would be kind of stretched at that point, so it's a little thicker for a strip there, but just kind of how the cloth would sit, I guess. But there's Nell. Alright, I'm gonna move on to this gal. Lutheria, the Lady of Dreams. She's going to have a bit of a more of a black base for her coloring. And then I have a couple greens that I picked up that I'm going to kind of brush over just to give a little bit of a glow for that. I'm going to kind of layer up a couple different colors. I have a foul green and a sick green from Vallejo. And I have the skin tone for her that I'm going to do. And black for most of her kind of outfit that she's got going. So her veil at the back here, most of kind of in all in here for the shoulder pads and down. But then as I get down into kind of here, this is gonna be black, but there's gonna be the green, like more of the greens in this, like down into the magic that's being cast, and then also up in here for the skull. I was thinking of doing maybe a bit of a purple highlight in there, but I think that's going to be too much based off of kind of the artwork in the actual game guide. She's more black with green undertones, so we're going to probably stick with that. Excuse me. All right, so let's get going on this because it's going to be a bit. I think we'll go with a bigger brush. Apologies. I need to find a paintbrush here properly, so 2 seconds. This is where the airbrush would come in handy, for sure. Still have no idea how I'm gonna vent that, though. Pick that up this weekend. Hello, viewers. see a couple people in the chat, or at least pop it in to say, see what's going on. Most of this is going to be black, but I'm going to try and avoid unnecessary spots. Because then it dulls the color a little bit. You got to do a few layers. So. Leave the cleavage clear and the face, the hair, things like that to try and keep that from being black. Thank you. get some black somewhere that we don't want that big of a deal. Just try and limit as much as we can. So you can see, I need to get the side of her outfit yet, and the wraps on her arms. Start moving down. This is all going to be black down here, so I'll get a bigger brush at that point. Just kind of blot that spot. I gotta find my paint. There it is. Hello, friend. I see you. Okay, that's working. I don't know if the YouTube chat is working or not, so let me know if that is not via other methods that folks have, so ping me on there. Discord or Instagram or whatever you need to. Oh, all models that I end up doing here will also be on Insta afterwards. We will have everything posted there, as that is our main method of showing off the models. Right, I was putting paint in my tray. Where did I put my paint? Pardon me. Oh, goodness. We're gonna take a pause. And get some water. So, excuse me. I'll be right back. All right, back. And I have some more light. Hopefully that helps for people to be able to see things a little easier. has so much detail to it. What I love is that one of my players is actually in watching the stream here, and her character, actually, this is her mother. She gets to fight her mom pretty soon. I'm so ready to throw things at the group. Yeah. She is so far. Not too bad. Don't think we're gonna get to our bronze dragon that we hate tonight, but that's okay. Some painting on the weekend, maybe Monday. I do a day stream on Monday because I work for a client in the US and it is Memorial Day coming up here, so I'll do some painting in the morning. tell you about Lutheria? The players already know, so that I don't give away any spoilers. She is... funny enough, of the two titans that the players are coming up against, she is the mad titan. She is insane. Has not been able to really get over that. Her brother and husband, because of course this is a Greek odyssey, Sidon, Lord of Storms, has tried to cure her madness in the past and failed to do so, but in the process of trying to do this, he imbued items with her madness. These items are weapons and armor that are enchanted to be able to do something. I'm going to say exactly what. Players will be coming up to that here pretty soon. They'll be able to see what that is. But, they, madness was imbued into these items, but she was not cured of said madness. Just able to transfer some of it, not realizing how deep her madness actually runs. So, he left her to her own devices. She sails around the Nether Sea, being pulled by another Titan that has been captured during the Titan War, which would be another brother. His name escapes me. But he is a Titan who has a fairly sad backstory. He's not doing well for himself, being enslaved by Lutheria. Not many people are doing well when enslaved by Lutheria, so that's not a surprise. But he is forced to pull her barge around the Nether Sea. And Lutheria lives on the barge with some of her servants, some of her worshippers. And these worshippers dote on her, follow every command. Lutheria loves to play games and tell jokes. She thinks that she is hilarious. Her jokes are of a certain demographic that would find them funny. But as the players have learned from other people in the Nether Sea, survive, you laugh at her jokes. Otherwise, if she finds you not laughing, she will sew your mouth shut. Has done that to plenty of people on the prison island, where people are taken when they break their oath, whatever oath that they have broken. The Inyeris, which are demons, but the Inyeris in this world have feathered wings of red feathers instead of angel white. They are battle hardened and ready to go. This kind of would be like Valkyrs. Norse mythology. or shield maidens, I guess, four or so. Female warriors. They are decked out in armor, and they have a multitude of weapons, and they try to capture their prey alive to drag them down to the Nethersea. And everyone who is on this prison island, Lutheria comes by once a year to tell jokes. Anyone who is caught not laughing, she will sew their mouth shut. Not a great way to live. There was one person on the island who has been there for several decades. Players learn that the jokes are not good at all, but if you suck it up and laugh at her jokes, you will be able to use your mouth. Lutheria also likes games. There is a game called 20 Squares in this world. When played by anyone, really, gods, mortals, demi-humans, fey creatures, there's kind of a known element that anything that is really said on or gambled with on in this game, there's usually a bit of an oath bound to people who play the game. And the games are watched over by deities of sorts that will make sure that nobody breaks their oath during the game. And the game is it's not, if you're caught cheating, bad things happen. But this person on the islands, or on the prison island, has stated that she has figured out that Lutheria is cheating. She doesn't know how, just that she is. She's passed on to the players for them to utilize when playing her. Players know that she can cheat somehow. They just don't know how, really. Couple locations. They're currently in a location in the Nether Sea that is called a prison cube. The prison cube has a timer on top. It is a giant hourglass. Affixed to the top of it there's about 3 centuries worth of sand left in the hourglass. before something happens with the prism cube. But so far, they have gone inside. They've been fighting some golems. They killed a couple purple worms. The purple worms were chained up, so they weren't as deadly. But they're the purple worms are basically being bred to feed the creature that is chained up in there. The creature that is chained up in there is a Tarrasque. My players are all level 10. You can bet how that's kind of going. But they still have some more of the prison cube to explore. They've been racking up the XP grind like crazy in this place. It has provided a buttload of XP. They are close to leveling up again. They are level 10, almost level 11 at this point. It's going wild. Oh, hello, Chantel. I see you in chat now. Chantel, has your DM allowed you to see your character yet? Or are you still waiting on that? Jump into a game so you can see your character. But I know that there are other requirements first and foremost, so I understand. When you do get in there, message me and let me know what you think of the print. I hope you like it. Well, let's be real. Most of the work was done by you for the modeling. I just stuck it in the printer and press the button and hoped for the best, as one would do when photocopying their butt. There's not much to it. It's not really talent kind of thing. And yes, I did use that as a reference. Good for black. As I put my hand all the way across the camera. Let's give Lutheria her debut on the on there now. Alright, I'm gonna let that just kind of get a minute for an air dry, and I'm gonna step away for 2 seconds, so I will be right back. Some skin tone color here. Let's go with a is actually fairly pale. So we're going with a... I actually ordered a pack of skin tone colors because I have like random this and that kind of pieces, but not a full set of actual good skin tone colors. So I ordered a set. I have actually been liking Vallejo paint a lot lately. So this is the one that we're using for our paintings, or for our skin tone colors at least anyway. I just realized that you can't read that. Let's see if I can flip. Nope, that's the wrong one. Haha. horizontal. There we go. Now you can read it. So we are going with Light Flesh from Vallejo for our colors, for the skin tone for her, at least anyway. I started painting with Citadel paints when I first got kind of going. And they're good. I still enjoy them, but I find Vallejo sits a little nicer on things. So if I didn't prime this model first off, paint would still sit. It would sit a little better than if it had been Citadel. At least that's my findings, anyway. For resin printing. I think we may have to do just a couple coats to get the right one. Upside down doesn't help you to be able to read the paints, though, unfortunately. Out to go blowing up my nose there for a second for that step when I stepped away, and my fiance there, she minimizes her screen. I'm like, what are you doing? She's like, planning. I'm like, planning what? My spells for the next game. I'm like, oh, okay. That's good to know. Zach, if you're still on the video here, I moved my mic around a little bit too, so let me know if the volume is still kind of wonky or anything. Or Chantel. Some of the plans that the players come up with are always fantastic to see. They don't always work, but I still love seeing what some of the stuff that they come up with is. My players are pretty resourceful, I'll give them that. Been some interesting things that have happened that they have done. I've also allowed some ridiculous magic item combinations that I 100% regret. Giving a monk ranged hits. I didn't think it was gonna bite me in the ass as much as it has. interesting trying to figure out how to actually hit a monk when they can run the hell away and basically hide from you. And when they move away, they have the ability to punch you as a reaction if you try to hit them and miss, because they also have 22 AC, 23 AC, something like that. I can't hit them. We're finally getting into the realm of me being able to hit them, because I don't have to actually roll to hit. The actual everything is more coming down to like spell saves. Well, there are spell saves that they're not good at, like charisma based things, and I can just like get them with something like that, and it's fun being able to actually hit them because they screwed up and not me. So there she is for the moment. Thank you. paste with some dry fully, and I touched it. Do it. All right, don't touch the face. But we will show it off. There she is. Okay. We need to figure out her hair. Her hair is a kind of a dirty blonde. Darker than I want, but that's okay. I always do some highlight streaks or something like that. I'm actually thinking I might do one Monday morning, but I try and do typically. I typically do like to do like live streams on like Sunday morning is when I usually do. But I need to get some painting done, so I was like, you know what? Let's just go do a live stream now. But yeah, Sunday mornings is usually when I like to do it. Monday I'll do one just instead of Sunday this weekend, just because it's Memorial Day in the US and I'm off, so. Oh no, she has a pumpkin on her head. Definitely gonna have to do some highlights on this. Aw, thanks, Chantel. You're actually my first subscriber. Okay, the hair doesn't look so much like a pumpkin now. I'm actually not upset with this. This looks really good. And I'm still gonna give her some highlights to her hair just to lighten things up a little more, just because it wouldn't make sense for Nell to have the hair color that she has without it, so. Go. What you think? Not bad, eh? I think the skull is going to be my most difficult part. I gotta paint the skull and then do the magic around it as well. I don't know if I'm gonna get her done tonight. I'll try and get at least the base colors on, the flat colors, and then do highlighting. Pardon me. Monday. Stay hydrated. Okay, so for the skull, I think I have a wraithbone color. Actually, I have a white that has a tint of green to it. I'm gonna use that instead. Tendrils of magic, I am going to do a mix of greens here, I think. Save that one for tinting the clothing. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to go with a base green. Angel green by Vallejo. So we'll do this as the base tendrils. And then we're going to mix in a little bit of this orc green. Orc skin green and this foul green, also Vallejo, and go with those as like swirls, the last two, do swirls off of the tendrils with that. So first off, let's get skull done, and then we'll do the tendrils. I think I'll have to call it there for tonight. Pardon me while I mix paint. moved. Fix it. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna get the magic tendrils done, and then we're gonna call our quits for tonight. Screen that we're gonna do. Thank you. right. Color is done. Do a dry brush of the orc skin. Enough of a color difference to see too much of that one, so we'll switch to the other. Maybe do a little bit of a mix of charcoal in there too, just to give a little depth. prepare for tonight. I'm actually happy with the tendrils. So Monday, we'll do some more painting. Touch up more her face here. Get her eyes and mouth and stuff in. Get these hairpins done. And then also the details kind of down on her belt here for the pouches and the skull. There, yeah, this stuff. And then just kind of do a bit of a wash for, I think I've got to do a dry brush of a green, a lighter green that I have. And then I also have a contrast wash. Maybe do turquoise. I also have one called Nightshade. That's the shade. That's what I'm called. Shade's not contrast. I also have I'll take a look at that and see, maybe. I also have a green contrast. Yeah, I'll have to play around, so. This is, pardon me, this is Lutheria. Round one, and I'll get some more done on Monday. So thanks for stopping by. I appreciate my friends popping in to see this. Like and subscribe and all the YouTube jazz that you're supposed to do. And yeah, I will have a stream up Monday morning, and we'll do some more painting. And then probably roll through, I'll probably do another stream midweek next week, and then probably back to my normal Sunday painting streams that I like to do. So, but yeah, that's it for now. Let me know what you think, and yeah, thanks for coming by again. Talk to you later. Take care. Bye-bye.